according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
As Jesus passed from there, he saw a man named Matthew sitting at the customs post. He said to him, "Follow me." And he got up and followed him. While he was at table in his house, many tax collectors and sinners came. And they sat with Jesus and his disciples. The Pharisees saw this and said to his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" He heard this and said, "Those who are well do not need a physician, but the sick do. Go and learn the meaning of the words, 'I desire mercy, not sacrifice. I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, this is the first time in 2 years of writing and delivering homilies that nobody's been writing down everything that we've done and spitting it back out. James, I think we're going to like this. A few weeks ago, Father Norman, James, and I had a planning session for today's Mass, and it was decided that I would be the deacon of the Word, and James would be the deacon of the altar. So when I looked up today's readings, and I saw that the gospel for today was the call of Matthew, I thought, well, that's cool. Matthew's called to be an apostle, James and I are called to be deacons. So naturally, my thoughts turned to the obvious parallel in our respective ministries. So I decided that I was going to look up everything I could about Matthew, start writing it down, and comparing. But you know, the more I researched on Matthew, it seems, the less I found. In fact, in some scriptural circles, he is known as the Phantom Apostle. Well, that wasn't looking good. I mean, nobody knows with any degree of certainty whatsoever what he did after the ascension, or where he did it. Nobody's even sure whether he died a martyr's death, or if he did, when and how. Aside from today's passage and a similar one in Mark's Gospel, all we have are the lists of the apostles in the four Gospels and a few very, very questionable legends. Okay, what we do know is that he was a tax collector in a fishing town called Capernaum. He was a part of a customs staff who worked for a regional fat cat that owned the franchise rights to collect taxes for the Roman Empire in that area. And as you're probably well aware, tax collectors in first century Palestine were not very popular. In fact, they were probably even more despised than our own IRS. They not only collected the amount prescribed by the government, but added a very generous portion of gravy for themselves. And being a Jew, Matthew was especially hated. Not only was he considered an extortionist, but a traitor to his people, and as such, he was prevented from entering the synagogue and practicing his faith, whatever faith he might have had. Mark's account adds one more detail to Matthew's identity, that he was the son of Alphaeus, which makes him the brother of the Apostle James the Less, and by marriage, a relative of Jesus. And, oh yeah, he wrote the gospel, his name on it. That's about it, though. But just says so little about Matthew